Hello, Mac crowd. Glad you've joined. Before guiding you through the hacks, let me mention that all the utilities I use here are either built natively into macOS or belong to Setapp, which is a one-stop app subscription service, so you don't have to buy any licenses to benefit from this video. Good start, right? Tip number one, torrenting on Mac. Shoot it. I know you're wondering whether it's even legal. Well, you can use torrent clients on Mac provided the files you're downloading aren't subject to copyright or distribution laws. So yes, it is. The common way to use torrent is to use uTorrent or BitTorrent, the original clients. However, both contain ads and can cause some security issues, so I use Folx Pro instead. Use the top search bar to type in your keyword and hit return, and then choose the appropriate file. Click download on the right-hand side. That's it. If you go like, nah, uTorrent is better, you should know that the uTorrent app is not available on macOS Catalina 10.15 because of 32-bit app architecture restrictions. You can either replace it with a web version or use an alternative. Tip number two, ditch AirPlay. I know a tool that gives you many more options on where to stream your content to. It's called JustStream, and it works with Smart TV, Apple TV, Chromecast, and whatnot really. So let me show you how to set it up. 1. Install and launch JustStream. It should appear in your menu bar. 2. Turn on your Smart TV. 3. Click on the plus button to choose the media files you want to play. 4. Select the device you want to stream to. There's the arrow next to the AirPlay icon at the bottom of the JustStream window you should click on. 5. Hit Start Streaming. Next, let's add some music. If you love custom ringtones, this hack is for you. You can use iTunes to create a unique iPhone ringtone. First, enter your music library and choose the track you'd like to use as a ringtone. Right-click the track, then hit Get Info and Options. Select the start and end time, should be a maximum 30 seconds, and click OK. Open Preference, General, and Import Settings. Set the import to AAC encoder if it's not set by default and save the changes. Go back to the track, right-click, and select Create AAC Version. You'll see the file listed twice in iTunes. Choose the new one and select Show in Finder. Change the file name from M4A to M4R for the ringtone. In iTunes, delete the file you created and replace it with the M4R file. You can drag it from Finder. Once you click on ringtones, your track should be there. Simply transfer it to iPhones next time you sync. Tip 4. For the folks who take good care of their Mac data, here's a trick on how to clone your drive and use it as a backup. Connect the external drive to your Mac. Go to Applications, select Utilities, and Disk Utility. Click on the external drive in the sidebar, Erase. Launch Disk Drill from Setapp, click Backup into DMG Image, OK. Choose your Mac's boot disk in the main window and hit Backup. Finally, go to the Erase drive and click Save. That's it. An exact copy of your boot drive will be saved as a disk image. Whenever you need to recover files from a disk image, mount the drive, double-click on the disk image in the Finder to mount it. Select the mounted volume in Disk Drill's main menu and click Recover. Follow the on-screen instructions to scan the volume, identify, and recover the files you need. Remember that you should never recover files to a failing hard drive, so choose a destination that you know is stable. Tip number 5, make your desktop spin with custom images. Yay! This is not a big crucial Mac hack you'll need, but it can help you make a desktop setup feel very personal. And who doesn't want that? So here's what to do. Install Wallpaper Wizard on Mac. Browse the app for the category you like, could be people, vehicles, or anything else. Choose the images you want to rotate. Click on the plus icon to add them to your role. You can also create your own roles by clicking on the plus icon of specific images. And if you just want one of the beautiful Mac desktop backgrounds from Wallpaper Wizard to be static, open it up and choose Set Desktop Picture. That's it. See how your desktop looks now. Tip number 6. How many times have you wanted a better Wi-Fi? I've found an app that can help you not only want, but always have it. So let's see how it works. 1. Install NetSpot from Setapp. 2. Set the slider to Survey and click on Start a New Survey. 3. Set up your environment and let the app generate a visualization of your wireless space. 4. Set the slider to Discover and see a breakdown of your wireless surroundings. 5. Switch across tabs to review the details. Done. Hope you don't have to complain about the quality of your network ever again. Well, that's a slight exaggeration. But NetSpot surely helps. A bit on the troubleshooting. The problem we all know is apps behaving strangely. You can always use force quit to such an app. However, it doesn't always work. If you're ready to go radical and delete the app that's hampering your work, you 1. Launch CleanMyMac X and go to Uninstaller. 2. Locate the app. In my case, it's PullTube. 3. Check the box and hit Uninstall. Ready. It's gone forever and you can continue your work. I really recommend having CleanMyMac X on your Mac. It can do much more than just uninstalling apps, like removing malware, old caches, etc. Really good one. Number 8. Oh, that's my favorite. There are lots of small things you toggle every day on Mac, like Bluetooth, connect AirPods, put computer to sleep, etc. This amazing app called OneSwitch basically takes it all into one place. So let's try it. Install OneSwitch. Click here in the menu bar. Ready. Now you can toggle across settings without going anywhere. And if some of the settings feel irrelevant, you can remove them in Preferences. Isn't that cool? Number 9. Overwritten files. Very often when you change the original file, you can place new data over the old, without saving the original. In this case, you'll need to recover overwritten files. There's a native way to solve it with Time Machine, but it will leave your Mac cluttered because Time Machine stores everything locally. To save space, I use Disk Drill. 1. So first install the Disk Drill app on Mac. 2. If the overwritten file has been stored on an external drive, connect the drive to your Mac. 3. Give the app permission to scan your drive. 4. Select the drive, then find the overwritten file and hit Restore. What could be easier? Generally, Disk Drill is a nice tool to have. Saves you from panic whenever you delete something important. Lastly, I hope your Mac is behaving well, but if it isn't, here's a quick tip on how to fix it. You'll easily find lots of troubleshooting guides on the web, but what's usually missing is the advice on how to fix 13-inch Mac Pro shutdowns. If that's your problem, you have to discharge the battery to 90% and below. Close all open apps, connect the charger, and switch to the sleep mode. Close the lid and let your MacBook Pro charge for about 8 hours. Turn on your computer and update it to the latest macOS version. That's it. Now your Mac Pro should fly. I really hope it's been useful for you. You can try all of the mentioned MacBook hacks right away. Setapp offers a free 7-day trial for all the apps I've used here. Thanks for watching, and feel free to share your honest feedback in the comments.